In this video, guys, I show all the locations for the clay pigeon shooters and all the locations for dancing in front of a fish trophy. So make sure to watch the entire video. I have all the locations for this week's challenges. Let's get straight into it. So yeah, subscribe, leave a like and comment. Alright, guys, welcome to another Fortnite video. So the challenges for week 8. Just dropped, guys. As you can see, brand new challenges this week. I thought they might delay them because it was saying coming soon, but they actually released on time this time as well. Anyways, let's get right into the challenges for week 8, guys. And here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna read through them really quick and I'll give you some tips, and then I'm gonna go ahead and show you how to do every single of the challenges if there's something specific to it. But anyways, guys, so the first challenge, and these are again kinda easy. The first challenge is visit Lonely Lodge and Retail Row in a single match. I mean, that one is pretty easy. The visit challenges, where you just have to drop to two different locations in one match, these are really easy. You can probably chain them together and do a bunch in one game. But anyways, next one is dance with the fish trophy at different named locations. So I'm gonna show you how to do that one in a little bit. Dance in front of 7 of these fish trophies. Third challenge is 6 shooter or heavy assault rifle eliminations. So basically, heavy assault rifle is the AK-47 that they just added to the game. So that one is kind of common drop. It starts from rare, the blue one, but I get it almost every game and it's really powerful. So you can just aim for the head, get the 2 eliminations, pretty easy. 6 shooter, it's kind of tricky with it. You know, it's the revolver pistol, but you can do it with the heavy assault rifle easily for sure. And these are the 3 challenges, these 3. They're not too bad, but next up, we have get a score of 3 on different clay pigeon shooters. Clay pigeon shooter over here next to Leaky Lake. It's really easy to find. The next one is get trick points in a vehicle, and you gotta get 250k trick points in a vehicle, which is again a really easy challenge. I'll show you a special place where you can just do it just like that, like super easy. Next up, we have visit different named locations in a single match. Hard. So this one is not too hard. There is 4 locations that are really close by to each other, and I'll show you those in a little bit once I'm doing the challenges. And the last one, the first stage is use a grappling hook. So that one, I don't know why it says hard. It's really not a hard challenge. But yeah, guys, anyways, let's get straight into completing these challenges. Alright, guys, so the first challenge is to visit Lonely Lodge and Retail Row in a single match. That one is easy. The next one is to dance in front of 7 of these fish trophies. And the first one, guys, is located at 3. Also, guys, next up, the second one is also really easy. That's the first one. The second one is you just want to enter this store, and right over here, you have another one to dance in front, so you can get 2 at the same time. Alright, guys, the second location is in Salty Springs, guys. So you gotta go to the main house. This is literally the first house in Salty Springs. You wanna go through, and then you gotta go actually downstairs. And once you're downstairs, the fish trophy is right here in the basement. It's pretty easy to find, guys. You just go to Salty Springs and you dance in front of it. Alright, guys, location number 3. You go to Dusty Devil, you enter the restaurant, and it's actually inside of this toilet right here. So that one is kinda easy to get to, so yeah, we got him. Alright, guys, the next location is this house in Lonely Lodge. There is 2 fishes right next to the fireplace, and there is another fish, but you only get the achievement once for here, so you can't do like 3 dances. But one dance, I mean, it's pretty good for Lonely Lodge. Alright, guys, location number 5 is inside the bunker of Lonely Lodge. And also, guys, if you didn't know, yesterday I did a video about it, about these teleporters that were just placed in here. It's a Season 7 event teaser, so make sure to check it out. First link in the description. But anyways, guys, the fishes are right over here on the second floor of the bunker. You have 3 fishes on the wall. So you basically want to drop down here, exit, go to the right, and these are the 3 fishes at the Wailing Woods bunker. Location number 5. Let's go to number 6. Alright, guys, location number 6 is at the broken building of Tilted Towers. Right over here, you have one of the fishes just laying on the floor. So that is location number 6, guys. This one is really simple to find. I just hope the fishes cannot be destroyed in the game, because somebody might just go through and destroy them. But they're probably not gonna be able to destroy them, let's be real. So yeah, you just gotta come to Tilted Towers and dance for location number 6. Let's go to number 7. Alright, guys, and location number 7, the last fish that you need for this challenge is in Shifty Shafts. This one is a bit harder to find. I mean, kinda. But anyways, you drop to Shifty Shafts and there is this one lodge over here. You get inside, there is a chest and the fish on the wall. So you can just, you know, dance with the fish, and it's pretty easy. So yeah, guys, these are all the fish locations. I hope you guys can find them and do this challenge really fast. Subscribe to the channel if you're new, and let's check out the next quest. All right, guys, so now I'll show you the quickest route to do the first pigeon shooter location. 250 points in a vehicle, and to get a vehicle really fast, guys. What you want to do is drop exactly over here next to Leaky Lake, and there is 100% spawn of a quad crusher. As you guys know, with the recent patch, they changed the spawn rate of the cars, or vehicles to 100%, so every time you come here, there is gonna be not one, but two quad crushers, guys. So what you wanna do is you wanna drop over here. We have a shotgun. We have a shotgun, which is gonna be useful later, but you can get the quad crusher as well. And you can either start doing points or just drive it to the first challenge. Alright, guys, so this over here is the first location of the clay pigeon shooter over here next to Leaky Lake. It's really easy to find. You can see it's down here, right next to the flush factory. I mean, above on flush factory. You would have to pin this as a location in order to find it, probably. But it is by the edge of the map. Anyways, you can see like this. Yeah, it is by the edge of the map. And what you gotta do basically here is you gotta enable this thing and it's gonna start shooting discs. And you gotta hit three of the discs to score three in a row, actually. So yeah, guys, that's one location. I'm gonna show you two more. So what you wanna do is activate it, and then it's gonna start shooting soon. Oh no! All right, we got it, we got it. Oh, it's a duck! Should I have not shot? Okay, it gave me a point, whatever. Oh, we got three, and that's it. You can just, I mean, you can let it go, or you can keep shooting. I mean, shotgun is not the best weapon for this, but see, we got the challenge, guys. That's the first one. I'll show you two more locations in a little bit. Alright, guys, so the next location is next to Pleasant Park. So over there you have Pleasant Park, to the left of Pleasant Park, down here, exactly right here on the map. It's kind of like an unnamed location. It's kind of hard to find, but it's below Haunted Hills and left of Pleasant Park. This is the piano from last week, well, a few weeks ago. And over here, guys, you have another pigeon shooter. You just gotta score three and you're good to go with this one as well. And the last one, guys, which is pretty much the easiest one to find, is the one next to Leaky Lake. Over here you can have another clay disc shooter. Here is it on the map, guys, if you need it. It's right on top of the lake, Leaky Lake or Loot Lake or whatever you want to call it, the new named area. So yeah, this one is really easy to get to as well, so you guys can just drop in and get all of this really simple. All right but if you're dropping over here, guys, you can get your quad crusher, right? You can get your quad crusher, and the easiest way to get stunt points or fly high and get 250k really easy is to come over here next to the rune area, guys, with the runes, and jump on one of the jump pads while they're still here, because I mean they would probably be removing them soon. But yeah, you come over here and you can choose any, but I'll just choose this one. You get one where you can get a lot of air and you just start spinning. Look at this, look at this, guys. 250k. Yeah, I forgot to say you had to land it, but it's okay, look at this. Alright, there we go. Literally, we just won. I need 5,000 more and somebody's shooting at me, what do you mean? But yeah, you can do it literally with only one jump, guys. There is also a challenge to visit four different name locations, and this is a really good game, and a really easy way to do it is to just go Leaky, then to Mato Temple, maybe Lazy Link's Wailing Hood, or Dusty. Oh! Dude, they keep shooting at me, just leave me alone! I'm here for the challenge. I am a friendly pumpkin, man. Just leave me alone. All right, here we go. We did the challenge, boys. Also, another tip, guys, is that if you, for example, go to Wailing Woods for a different named location, it gives you the... Yeah, look at this. I just did it. I did all four by just going Leaky Lake, near Lazy Link, near Tomato Temple, or near Wailing Woods. So that was a really easy challenge, guys. Yeah, we just did this. We completed a lot of the challenges for this week. So now you can just leave your match, guys, and it's fine. Okay, don't leave the match. Leaving the match was a mistake. But anyways, you get the point, guys. We complete in this one only. We completed. We could have completed Lonely Lodge in Retail Row. We can dance with 7 fish trophies. These are kind of easy with the location shown. 6 shooter or heavy assault rifle eliminations. You can do that as well. You get a score of 3 on different clay pigeon shooters. I just show you how to do one, and I will show you 2 more locations, guys. So that was pretty easy. Then we have to get the trick points. I did get them with just one jump, so that was kind of easy as well. Visit different name locations. We did it. That was a really easy route that I showed as well. Use the grappling hook. Still haven't done that one, guys. But anyways, that seems to wrap it up with all the challenges for week 8, guys. So yeah, these are pretty easy to do. You can just do them almost in a single game again. It's just that, you know, I shouldn't have left. I didn't know they fixed it. Before, you used to be able to just leave the game, join a new one, and you're good. But I guess I should have just taken fall damage or something, and it would have worked. But anyways, guys, as you can see, my battle pass is on tier 63. Also, let's do a quick item shop, because every time I do these videos, somebody asks about the item shop. We have the Ravage and the Heyman and the Straw Ops just, you know, re-going into the entire shop again. We have the new, well, it's not new. We have the Tomato Head and Burger, Der Burger skins as well in the shop, guys. These are okay. I'm not a big fan. I have the Tomato Head. I think it was in season 3 or something. I don't know if I bought it or if it was just, you know, with the season pass. We have Snorkel Ops, which is a scam. I don't like this skin. We have this one. And this one is okay. Just, I don't know, nothing too special. We have Dance Therapy, though. And if you guys want me to buy Dance Therapy, it costs 800 V-Bucks. So one like equals one V-Bucks. You guys should leave 800 likes. And if this video hits 800 likes, I'll buy Dance Therapy. And we have the Night Slicer in the shop. I mean, that one is kind of cool, but nothing too special. Anyways, guys, though, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the like button if it helped you. Make sure to subscribe if you want to see these videos more often. You can see them every single week. I'll do the tutorials for all the challenges. I'll try and make them better, easier to find every single time, guys. And I'll see you next time for another challenge week. So, yeah, subscribe, leave a like, and comment which is your favorite challenge or how many games it took you to do it.